Welcome viewer, welcome to Artistry. I'm your presenter, Tirus Wanyoike. We continue with our program on manufactured boards, because we realized that these boards, we use them every day in our houses, in perhaps the unit you are placing your television on, maybe made of one of these. So we considered cheap board last time, MDF. This is solid wood. This is solid wood again, laminated. Now, today we move to this other type of manufactured board. We call it the MDF ply. MDF ply, ply we mean plywood, but now we call it MDF ply because it looks plywood, but it's made of MDF. So it's about 4 millimeter in thickness, and it is normally made of the same stuff as MDF. It's a medium density fiber. So the medium density fiber has been compressed to a good extent for it to be hard a bit, and then it will be used to do some finishing, especially on the back side of your unit, where we used the normal plywood. Now, if the unit is made of MDF, from the inside it will look MDF, so we don't want to destroy that pattern at the back by using the normal plywood that we have. So we have this MDF board, MDF ply, so we use it at the back side of the units, especially the TV unit, the wall unit. So it is used in almost a similar way as the plywood, but this is made of MDF. So a very fine groove is made in the back, and then it will be fitted. So the standard size comes as 8 by 4, that is in feet. In millimeters, it is 1220 by 2440. So that is a standard size, just similar to every other manufactured board. So it's important to note the difference between that and the plywood. The plywood is here, and as the name suggests, it is a ply. It is made of plies, and then it is wood. This one is now not MDF, it is not chipboard. This is wood. The wood is peeled into thin plies. Ply will mean it has three thin parts. So one part, one ply is running, the grains are running like this. The middle ply is thicker than this ply, and the grains are running like this. And then the last one at the back will run exactly the same as this one. So this is wood, as the name suggests. It is a number of plies, but it is made of wood. So the plies are made in the factory, where the logs are prepared and then they are peeled. Peeling meaning they are produced in 1 millimeter thickness, 2 millimeter thickness, and so on and so on, and then they are glued together to form a big sheet of plies. So three plies will make the three ply that we know, we buy from the hardware. So this is ply wood, it is made of wood. This is MDF ply, so it's a ply, 4 millimeter ply, but made of MDF. So if I would split a little bit of it here, you could see what is inside. It is compressed, and then it could even come out. You can see looks of more of a compressed board, but for the plywood it will be difficult for me to split it, and if I did, it would come out very rough. And this looks exactly wood. It is wood that has been peeled, a log has been peeled, and then it has been prepared to form the plywood. So we have another product here. This one It is still plywood, but we call it veneered plywood. Veneered in the sense that it has been added value using a veneer here. So this veneer, especially the one I'm holding right here, it's a mahogany veneer. So in the inside, it could be made of this kind of plywood. And then the last veneer on top, because we said we have three plies. The plies are made of veneers. So ply will mean there is one layer, a middle one, and a top one. So the top one here and the underneath one, they are made of mahogany. So mahogany is a high quality species. It's the same one here. So if we want this piece of wood to look mahogany, then we will use a veneer on top of this piece and it will just look mahogany. And a good example is also what we have in this blockboard. So this is blockboard, and then we have a mahogany veneer on top. So we have all these possibilities in the woodwork or in the joinery sections. You may have the MDF ply. The MDF ply will either be painted or it could remain the way it is because it is used at the back of the units, the TV unit, or even the entertainment unit, the cupboards, wardrobes, and so on and so on. So since nobody will be regularly seeing the services, they could be left either plain or they could be painted. We have the plywood that is stronger in structure than the MDF ply. So in structure, it is very important as well to notice that plywood is stronger than MDF ply. Veneered plywood is strong as well as plywood, but also value has been added to it. Now we have a more beautiful plywood than the ordinary plywood that we have. So depending on the use, depending on where we want to use and the value we want to put to it, we either use MDF ply at the back where we don't need a lot of visibility, and again strength is of no much relevance. Now where we want it a bit stronger but the appearance is not a big deal, then we would use the ordinary plywood where we could even paint it after use. Some people even use it for ceiling. If you want a cheap ceiling, then you just get a few pieces of plywood and then you paint them and that is it. Then where you need good appearance or very nice finish, especially in wall paneling, in other other high quality finishes, then you use the veneered plywood. It could also be used at the back of the TV unit, at the back of your wardrobe, where you would like to add value to the item that you are making. So we have also considered the veneered blockboard. So blockboard is made of thin strips, as you can see, thin strips of wood. They have been laminated and then a ply has been put on top and bottom. They have been compressed together, and then the last ply up here, about 1 millimeter, makes a lot of difference. 1 millimeter will make the blockboard to appear better as compared to this blockboard. The same blockboard, this is the same blockboard, but now one value has been added to it so that we can now have a more beautiful blockboard than the ordinary blockboard that we have. So for this one, we have both sides being veneered. So of course it will be expensive, and I think it is the most expensive manufactured board of the boards that I have here. And again, we have thicknesses ranging from 12 millimeters all the way to 25, from half an inch, 3/4 inch, up to 1 inch. You could have it, and then you have your item well valued. So we have that option as well. And since we have quite a wide range of manufactured boards, we'll take a break, and then once we are back, we will be able to see more of these manufactured boards and their uses. So keep tuned.